Welcome to the Help for Leaders podcast. I'm Stacey Harris, and I'm passionate about showing leaders the power of communication and how it can transform their organizations, from Fortune 500 boardrooms all the way to brand new startups. As a leader, your actions and your words transform people and your company culture. So join me as I share tips and insights for elevating your leadership abilities as well as your team's performance. Let's dive right in. Appreciating and flexing toward the high D. That's what we're going to be talking about today on the Help for Leaders podcast. Welcome back. I'm Stacey Harris. I'm so glad that you've joined me today. I really want to give you tips and strategies on communication, specifically toward that very direct person. So I want you all to think about someone in your life that's very direct. They're adventuresome. They're competitive. They're all about results. They're quite assertive. They focus on tasks. They love a challenge. You know that person? Are you thinking of them? I want to give you strategies to communicate more effectively with that individual. We all have those people in our lives. Maybe you are that person. But I want you to learn how to appreciate the differences in that particular style. This is going to be a series of four different episodes where we're going to talk about each of the behavioral styles, and we're going to really lean into appreciating our differences and learning how to communicate most effectively. Because if we don't learn to appreciate our differences, we can drive each other crazy. And so I want to help you really learn to see the differences and realize I can't do it all. I cannot do all of these things that my team needs, that my family needs, that my friend group needs. So how are we going to really fill in all the gaps? And that's learning to appreciate our differences and learning to communicate more effectively. So I want to give you some strategies for communicating with that direct, that ambitious, that goal-oriented individual. Okay, so first of all, think about that person. I really want you to have somebody in mind that really kind of checks all those boxes that I was talking about so that you can really apply this knowledge that I'm about to give you. So first of all, when you're communicating with that direct person, you need to be clear, you need to be specific, and you need to be to the point. Don't ramble, don't waste their time, don't continue on and on and on. Just be specific. That's number one. Number two, stick to business. Don't chit-chat with that person, especially in a business context. Obviously, in a friend group, you're not going to be able to maintain that level of directness, but it's at work, on your teams, when you're communicating, especially if it's via Zoom or a Teams meeting where we're still in that virtual rather than face-to-face, or you have half your team virtually, half your team face-to-face, stick to business. That's really honoring of that direct person. They don't want chit-chat. That's number two. Come prepared. Don't be late to the meeting. Don't be disorganized. Have all of the information and packaged in a very neat, presentable way. That is going to really communicate value to that direct, ambitious person. Present things logically, very consistently. They love logic. Plan your conversation in a very efficient manner. Don't leave loopholes or anything cloudy. That's very frustrating for the direct person. Ask some specific questions and lead with the word what. What do you need? What's the problem? What's going on? What's happening? What's the bottom line? What do you need? That's consistently a question that direct individuals kind of lean into because they love to solve problems and they love to lead with answers that are going to really fill in the gaps for that what question. So providing facts and figures, all about success. Lead with success. That's helpful for that direct individual. Don't provide solutions for them. They want to figure things out on their own, but provide some options very succinctly in a clear format. Also, don't disagree with them personally. Disagree with the facts. You want to create a win-win situation for that very direct individual And then lastly, I want you to make sure that you're providing alternatives and choices for them. Don't make decisions for them. Give them options. That's super helpful in communicating with that very direct individual. Now, at the beginning, you heard me say that we want to also talk about what we appreciate about this style, because if we can't learn to appreciate our differences, it can be very big pieces that cause disconnect. And we really want to bring connection, not disconnect. So here are some of the things that I personally appreciate about direct individuals. They're all about the bottom line. They can organize things and think big picture and then focus on results. I appreciate that. They're self-starters. They'll take initiative. They'll go after things faster than any other style. So being a self-starter, I also love that they're visionaries. They're always looking forward. They're not looking back. They're constantly pushing you forward. That's something that I really appreciate about that direct style. And hopefully you do too, if those individuals are on your team. They place a high value on time, on their time, on your time. They don't want to waste time. They're all about efficiency and practicality. So that high value of time, I appreciate that about the direct individual. They're competitive. They're quite competitive. And if you are too, you will love kind of competing with that style. So high Ds, very competitive individuals. I want them on my team when we're doing something. They initiate lots of activity. They're always thinking through, could we do this? Let's do this. Let's try this. That's great on teams, especially if we're kind of getting stuck in status quo. So I appreciate that about the direct individual. Also, they do challenge the status quo. They're quite tenacious individuals and very innovative. So what do you think about the individual that you're thinking about? What do you appreciate about their style? I'd love to hear from you. I'd love for you to share this podcast with someone that you know that's very direct and let them know, hey, I want to learn how to communicate more effectively with you. I also appreciate these things that you bring to the table, that you bring to our team. So think about those direct individuals in your life. We all know them. Maybe they're family members, maybe they're friends, maybe they're colleagues at work. But I hope you'll share this episode with them and really lean into what you appreciate about them and let them know. I'd love to hear from you as well. Let me know what you appreciate about that direct style. I hope you'll join me next week because we're going to talk about the outgoing individual, strategies to communicate effectively, and really lean into what we appreciate about that outgoing individual. Thank you for joining us today. You have the potential to communicate, engage, and lead with significant impact, and my goal is to help you do just that. Whether you're trying to get that next big promotion, scale your small business, or manage a team of thousands, there's always room for growth, and I can help you get there. Go to disc-report.com and find out what style of leader you are by downloading my free ebook on communication. Until next time, lead well and prosper.